Hey YouTubers, it's Brent from Upper Corner Hockey. Today I'm going to show you how to sauce pass or saucer pass. I had a guy at hockey the other day, maybe in his early 40s, says to me, he says, how do you sauce so well? And I said, you never learned? He said, no, I never learned. So I gave him a few tips, and all of a sudden, on the second shot, he's saucing it like a king. So I figured, you know what? He's like, he goes, you should do a tutorial on it. So I said, you know what? Maybe, you know, I've seen a lot on the internet. There's a lot of good ones, but I figured, hey, why not? So maybe I can pass along some knowledge. I can't take full credit. My friend Ryan Pizzo told me about this one. I kind of knew it, but he helped me perfect it. So it's really... It was really, you know, passed down. But isn't that what hockey's all about? You teach your friends and you help people out. So what you're going to want to do is, you know, obviously you're going to need a hockey stick. This one's just a blade cut down for demonstration purposes. You're going to want to have your hands passive through the shot. You're going to start the puck off at the heel. You kind of just a little bit, stay a little bit behind the puck, and you kind of just chip it so it gets it get lift off the puck, and then you let the puck roll right up off the stick as you're moving your hands across your body, kind of like a slicing motion. It's real easy to do. It's one of those things that you guys should practice. The distance one is a little bit easier than the closer one, but all basically you're going to do is for a shorter distance, you just have a shorter follow through. Sometimes that actually makes it a little harder, because it's a lot easier to, because we're so used to following through with our shots. The one thing you can't do when you're saucing or doing a saucer pass is you don't want to pick up the stick and then roll your hands over. It could work sometimes with a long distance one, but your ultimate goal is to get that puck in the air over the defender and then slap flat on the ice. It almost hits like a suction cup if you do it right. So I did some shots on the ice the other day, just for some examples, and let's check them out. All right, so you're gonna have the puck in a forward position of your stance, knees bent, have the puck at the heel of the blade, move your blade about 1 to 2 inches back, and then follow through, slicing across your body, using your shoulders, and your hands are passive, and follow through with the shot. The puck should run right up the blade and sauce perfectly. All right, here's some examples from behind the shot. You can see the knees are bent, puck's at the heel of the stick, and then you just kind of follow through across your body. It's as easy as that. The ultimate goal is to have the puck slap flat on the ice. You can see here in the video. All right, YouTubers, that's pretty much it. I'm going to leave you with some running video of me saucing on the ice. I hope it helped. And, you know, comment below if you have any other questions, and I'll try to help you as much as I can. So, like, click, subscribe, and all that stuff, and hopefully I helped you out. Happy hockey. Later, guys. Hey hockey YouTubers, it's Brent from Upper Corner Hockey. Today I'm going to do a little